I welcome you to my channel Learn with Pharmacy. In today's lecture, we are going to see detail about colloidal dispersion and classification of colloidal dispersion system, that is also known as dispersed system of colloid. So first we will see colloidal dispersion. Colloidal dispersion is a heterogeneous system which is made up of dispersed phase and dispersion medium. We will try to understand that with example. Dispersed phase means solute. Dispersed phase means solute. And dispersion medium means solvent. Dispersed phase means solute to be added. Dispersed phase means the particle. Dispersed phase means solute to be added. And dispersion phase means solvent in which solute is to be added. The solute and solvent combines together and form solution. Solution means mixture of solute and solvent. And the term dispersed phase and dispersion medium combines together, that is known as dispersed system or that is also known as colloidal system. So simple definition, that is heterogeneous system which is made of dispersed phase plus dispersion medium. In this one, system is dispersed as very fine particle in another substance called dispersion medium. The particle size of dispersed phase ranges from 1 nanometer to 1 micron or micrometer. The main criteria for dispersed phase is particle size should be in the range of 1 nanometer to 1 micrometer. 1 micrometer means particle size of 1000 nanometer. In colloidal dispersion, the particle size should be in the range 1 nanometer to 1 micrometer. Example are glue and starch. So next point, that is general classification of dispersion system. This is not the main classification of dispersion system, that will be involved in next point. So the general classification, it is classified in three terms, that is molecular dispersion, coarse dispersion and colloidal dispersion, that is also known as colloids. So molecular dispersion, that we will see first. These are those dispersion in which particle size of dispersed phase is less than 1 nanometer, that is molecular dispersion. These are invisible in electron microscope due to very small particles. Their particle also pass through semi-permeable membrane. Example of molecular dispersion, that is oxygen, nitrogen and other gases present in the atmosphere and glucose. Second, that is coarse dispersion. These are those dispersion in which particle size of dispersed phase is more than 1 micron or micrometer, coarse dispersion. Less than 1 nanometer, that is molecular dispersion. And they are easily visible in ordinary microscope also. Their particle size are somewhat large, bigger as compared to molecular dispersion. So they are easily visible in ordinary microscope. And they are also written in normal filter paper. Particle also settle down under gravity. And in the gravity, the particles are settled down and forms the layer. Example of coarse dispersion, that is suspension. Third classification, that is colloidal dispersion, that is also known as colloids, that we had already seen in the introduction. These are those dispersion in which particle size of dispersion phase is in the range of 1 nanometer to 1 micron or micrometer. 1 micron or micrometer, that is 1000 nanometer. In the range of 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer or 1 nanometer to 1 micron. and they cannot be visible in ordinary microscope but can be visible through electron microscope. Example, that is milk, and they are separated through semi-permeable membrane. So now the next point, that is general characteristics of colloidal particle. We had already seen this molecular dispersion, colloidal dispersion, coarse dispersion. This term is same and the information involved here is also same, but the point as per as syllabus is mentioned, so we will see this. So the characteristic or property are particle size range. In molecular dispersion, the particle size range is less than 1 nanometer, and in colloidal dispersion, particle size is between 1 nanometer to 1000 nanometer, and in coarse dispersion, particle size ranges more than 1 micron. And according to visibility, in molecular dispersion, particles are invisible in electron microscope. In colloidal dispersion, particles are visible in electron microscope, and in coarse, particles are not visible in normal microscope. Diffusion rate. The rapid diffusion takes place in molecular dispersion. In colloidal dispersion, the diffusion rate is very slow, and in coarse dispersion, the diffusion doesn't take place. According to separation is not possible in molecular dispersion. Separation is possible in colloidal dispersion through semipermeable membrane. Separation is also possible in coarse dispersion through filter paper. And nature of molecular dispersion is homogeneous. Nature of colloidal dispersion, that is heterogeneous. Nature of coarse dispersion, that is also heterogeneous. Example of molecular dispersion is oxygen, nitrogen, other gas present in the atmosphere, and glucose. Colloidal dispersion, example, that is milk. And coarse dispersion, example, is suspension. So the last point, that is classification of dispersed system. This is the main classification of dispersed system. Generally, many times the question is asked, what is colloidal dispersion, and classify dispersed system. So you have to write this point in the exam. So on the basis of their dispersion phase and dispersion medium, it is classified. So classification is based on dispersion phase. That is, dispersion phase means substance which is dispersed, and dispersion medium means the substance in which it is dispersed is called dispersion medium. So dispersed phase and dispersion medium, there is very simple trick to remember this chart. That is, in dispersed phase mention solid liquid gas and solid and liquid, and in dispersion medium mention solid liquid and gas. Why gas and gas is not possible, that we will discuss in next point. First we will discuss when the solid dispersed phase is there and dispersion medium is also solid, then the system will be, that is, solid solution. Example, that will be colloidal gold. And when the dispersed phase will be liquid and dispersion medium will be also solid, then the system will be gel. Example, that will be gel, waxes, etc. Dispersed phase will be gas and dispersion medium will be solid, then the name system will be solid foam. Example will be foam rubber. When the dispersed phase will be solid and dispersion medium will be liquid, then the name system will be sols. By mistakenly here solution is written, but that is not solution, that is sols, SOLS. Example will be moist paint and protein and milk. Moist paint and protein. Milk is not the example of solid liquid. When the dispersed phase will be liquid, dispersion medium will be also liquid. Then the name system will be emulsion. Example will be milk. When the dispersed phase is gas and dispersion medium is liquid, then the name system will be foam. An example will be soda water. And when the dispersed phase will be solid, dispersion medium will be gas, then the name system that will be aerosols of solid. Example of aerosols of solid are smoke. When the dispersed phase is liquid, dispersion medium is gas, then the name system will be aerosols of liquid. Example of aerosols of liquid are fogs and clouds. So here 8 terms are mentioned, but the 9th term that is not possible, that is gas and gas, because gas and gas is not formed because gas mixes in gas homogeneously, and the criteria for colloidal dispersion should be heterogeneous. As already discussed in the definition, it is a heterogeneous system. So gas and gas is homogeneous, so it is not possible. So here we had completed our today's topic, that is colloidal dispersion, classification of colloidal dispersion, and classification on the basis of general point. And we had also discussed general characteristic of colloid particles. So like and subscribe to this channel for more videos. Thank you.